In this video, we're going to compute the period for a disc that's been drilled off-center and used as a physical pendulum. So we're given the mass of the disc as 1.2 kilograms and its radius is 15 centimeters, and we're told that we've drilled a hole in it 10 centimeters from the center of the disc. We then set the disc on a pin and release it from a small angle and allow it to oscillate. And to find the period of oscillation, we're going to have to bring in several prior results, and I'll post links to those videos as we bring these in. First, we need a reminder of our result for the period of a physical pendulum. So that turns out to be 2 pi times the square root of the moment of inertia of the object, and that's measured with respect to the actual rotation axis about that pin, divided by the mass times little g, the acceleration of gravity, times the separation distance between the rotation axis and the center of mass of the object. Second, we need a quick reminder of the parallel axis theorem. So this is going to allow us to compute the moment of inertia of the disc with respect to that off-center hole. And the parallel axis theorem tells us that all we have to do there is take the moment of inertia of a disc with respect to its center of mass, and then add in this extra term, mr squared, where that r is the distance between the two axes, in other words, the distance between the center of mass of the disc and the actual rotation axis 10 centimeters away. And finally, here's a quick reminder of the moment of inertia of a disc rotating about its center of mass. And what we mean here is that we're using a rotation axis perpendicular to the plane of the disc and passing through the center of mass. And we have this classic result. The moment of inertia is 1/2 times the mass times the radius of the disc squared. So given all these prior results, there's actually not a lot of work to do here. We just have to put everything together real quick. And the first thing I'm going to do is find the moment of inertia with respect to our rotation axis at that 10 centimeter mark. So we're using the parallel axis theorem here, and the moment of inertia with respect to the center of mass is 1/2 m big R squared. And then I have to tack on this extra term right here, m r center of mass squared, where that little r center of mass is the distance between the two parallel axes. So symbolically, we use a little r for that in this problem. So there's our moment of inertia, and then we just plug into the formula for the period of a physical pendulum. So we have 2 pi times the square root of I in the numerator here. That's 1/2 m big R squared plus m little r squared, then divided by mg times r center of mass. And again, we're using a little r for that separation distance between the center of mass and the axis that we're actually rotating around. Now notice that m's are going to cancel out here. And then in the next step, I'm going to go ahead and clear the complex fraction by multiplying the top and bottom inside that square root by 2. So in our numerator, we're left with big R squared plus 2 little r squared. And in our denominator, 2g little r. And we'll go ahead and plug numbers into this right now. But there's a comment that I want to make on a limiting case that we can study in the symbolic solution. But for now, let's just get the number on this. Big R is 15 centimeters. Note that I switched that to 0.15 meters. And little r is 10 centimeters. We call it 0.1 meters here. And we'll use 9.8 for g. And when I run the numbers on this to 3 significant digits, I get 0.925 seconds for the period of oscillation. So the problem's done, but I want to go back to the symbolic solution of the problem and test out a limiting case here. So what I'm thinking about is, how should this period vary as our hole gets drilled closer and closer to the center of rotation? And one way to get clarity on that is to actually look at the limit as r is approaching zero. So we're trying to find the limit of the period as r goes to zero. And we can just do some quick algebraic simplifications here to figure out the limit. In the numerator inside this square root, as little r approaches zero, that 2r squared term becomes negligible in comparison to the big R squared term, and that's just a constant up there. But in the denominator, I have little r approaching zero. So inside this square root, I have a denominator approaching zero, while the numerator stays finite and constant. And that means t is approaching infinity. So now we have to think about whether or not this makes sense. And all we're really saying here is, if I just drill the hole right in the center of the disc and then I give it a little spin, then we're not going to see any oscillations at all. Provided that friction is negligible, the disc will just keep spinning in one direction forever. So that is an infinite period, and that makes sense. So if you happen to be a physics teacher, I highly encourage you to incorporate a lab on this in your course. It's very simple to find materials to do this in the classroom. Now for me, I happened to find metal discs available at my local metal shop, and then I just drilled them off center, and I use high-speed steel pins that I got off Amazon, and just put those in a clamp, and we have a handy physical pendulum. But it could be as simple as just picking up a wood disc at a hardware store and drilling a big enough hole in it to fit a pencil through it, and you can still get good data to compare against the theoretical calculations here.